students, how are you all? I hope everybody is safe and doing well at your homes. Welcome to this session, and in this session, as you are aware now, that we are going to talk about verbs. Verbs are a very important part of a sentence in English language, whether we are writing it or speaking it. Why? Because there can be no sentence in English language without using verb. If we take into account the fact that even the smallest and grammatically correct sentences in English are nothing but verb, like go, sit, no, yes, they convey a complete meaning when they are used, and they are verbs and they are proper sentences. So verb becomes a very important part to learn for us. It is an integral, and it is, I will say, the most important part of the part of speech, because if we get a good hold on using correct verbs, our task of talking and writing English is 50% done. Yes, it's 50% done. And the videos which you are going to go through, the sessions which you are going to go through, are aiming at the same output, that you are able to use correct verbs. In this video, we are going to learn about the definition, the functions, and also the types of verbs, so that you can understand better what the verbs are, what category they fall in, and how are they to be used. So let's continue our learning with SJEC online classes, and let's move forward to our definition section first. So let's take a close look at what is the definition of verbs. The definition of verb is that verbs are those sentences which describe an action, an occurrence, or a state of deed. Verbs form a very important part of sentences and question sentences in English. So any word in English language which is used to describe any action, which you know as karma, so action, or an occurrence can be any event which is going to happen or which is about to happen or which had happened, anything, or a state of being. State of being means it can be either of physical, mental, or mechanical. These three states can be covered when we talk about state of being. Kisi avastha mein hona is state of being. So this is the definition, students, which we need to remember about verbs. And as I said earlier in my video, the quick remembering point for verbs should always be that verbs are action words. Now let's take a look at what are the functions of a verb in a sentence. After understanding what is the definition, if we will understand what are the functions of the verb, it will help us to learn and use these things very effectively in our sentences. Okay, so functions of the verb we need to understand. Now, the first function of the verb is, verb tell us in a sentence what a person is doing. That means, in a sentence, we use verbs to tell us what is being done by the subject. That we do in active voice sentences. Second function of the verb is, it tells us what is being done to some person or thing. So second function of the verb becomes that verb tells us what is being done to an object. So first function is what a subject is doing. The second function is what is being done to the object, to an object. And third, one of the most important functions of the verb is, it tells us the time of action. It tells us what is the time of the action in the sentence, whether we are writing it or speaking it. And verb also tells us what a person is. That means it also tells us about the profession of some person. Like it says, he is a doctor, I am a teacher, you are a student. So, like that, verb also tells us what a person is. Right? So, these are the functions of the verb which we need to remember, and also the definition is there on your screen. Revise it and learn it for better understanding. In the next part, we are going to study about the types of verbs. So let's move further and study our next topic, which is types of verbs. Okay, so now let's continue talking about the types of verbs. The first type of verb which we see here on the screen is auxiliary verb. Auxiliary verb is also known as helping verbs. So by either of these names you can remember them. What are auxiliary verbs? They are the family members of be, have and do. Be family members are is, am, are, was, were. Have is, has, had, have. And do family is do, did and does. Also the negative form of these sentences like didn't, doesn't, don't will also be included in these type of verbs. So auxiliary verbs are used together with the main verb to show the verb's tense or to form a negative or a question sentence. Remember this? Example is given of a question over here. Does Sam write his own reports? So the helping verb does is used over here, and since it is used in the starting, since it is used before the subject, which is called subject inversion technique, so it becomes an interrogative sentence over here, and that's an example for you. Second type of verb given here is modal verb. What are modal verbs? They are also a kind of helping verb, dear students. They are can, could, will, would, shall, should, may, might, ought to. All these are modals. They also act as an helping verb, and they are used to express ability, possibility, permission and obligation. Obligation is something which you are supposed to do. So modal verbs are used for these three four points, which is yes, ability, possibility, permission or obligation. Okay. Third type of verb is transitive verb. Transitive. What do you understand by transitive? Transitive is an adjective. So what is the noun in it? It is transit. What does transit mean? Transfer from one place to another. So what will be a transitive verb? Transitive verb is a verb which transfers its action onto some object. That is a transitive verb. Transitive verb or action of the verb is transited or passed over to an object. Like for example, she ate the fruits. Over here, the action of eating is being transferred to the fruits. So what was being eaten? Fruits. If we remove fruit from here and we just write she ate, then it becomes intransitive verb, because in intransitive verb, action of verb does not transit or pass over to an object. Okay, like the example over here, or the earlier example you can consider, she ate, the cat sneezed, I jumped, he sat. So everywhere in the same place, these verbs are intransitive verb. Now, he sat on a sofa. So same verb, the form is not changing, same of the form of the verb is becoming transitive or intransitive, depending upon whether it is transferring its action to an object or not. If it is transferring, transitive. If it is not transferring, intransitive. Next is stative verb. Stative verb relates to the state of being. It can also talk about a thought or an emotion, but not an action. So stative, it will always talk about some state. As I told earlier, state means samavastha, a state or a condition in which a person or thing or an event is. So stative verbs will always talk about a state of being. According to definition, it can be either mental, physical or mechanical. right? Example over here is he feels elated. Now elated is an internal action. It is not requiring any physical action. So it will be covered or it will come under stative verb. Next, sixth is action verb. It expresses physical and mental action. So mostly these mental actions and all are covered in stative. However, it can also fall in the category of action verb. But action verb mainly talks about the actions, the physical actions done by the subject. Example, she is walking in the park or he believes that it can be done. So she is walking, it's a physical action and that is why it will fall under the category of action verbs. What are regular and irregular verbs, children? Regular verbs are those verbs which take ED or D to the base form of the verb to create the past forms. Means any verb which becomes past tense either by adding D or ED at the end of it is called regular verb. All other verbs are called irregular verbs. Simple to remember. Irregular verbs don't take on a regular D or ED or IED spelling patterns of the simple past or past participle. For example, catch never becomes catched. It always becomes caught. However, play can become played. So play, regular verb, caught, irregular verb. So in this section, we learned about auxiliary verbs and modal verbs, transitive and intransitive verbs, stative and action verbs, regular and irregular verbs. Now, let's move to the next section, which is discovering and learning some more verbs. Here it is. The next verb which talks about is phrasal verbs. Phrasal verbs, dear students, are a combination of a preposition and a verb, wherein the original meaning of the verb completely changes in the phrasal verb. This is to be learned especially by class 11 and 12 students, phrasal verbs. Till class 10, you deal with verbs and prepositions separately in your papers. However, 11th onwards, you deal with phrasal verbs instead of prepositions. It is an interesting topic. So phrasal verbs made with a main verb and another word, which can be either preposition or a participle or an adverb, as I said, and it forms a meaning different to the main verb. For example, a burglar will often break a window to break in. Now break a window, here the verb is break, that means torna, break in. Break in is to get in without the permission of someone. So the break meaning is totally changed over here. Break in is a phrasal verb, which means to try to get in without proper permissions. Next, finite verb, important verb to remember again, students. Finite verbs are those verbs which show tense and are conjugated to agree with the subject. So finite verbs are those verbs which will show us the tense in the sentence and they will always be used according to the subject verb agreement. The basic rule of subject verb, there are 14 odd rules we need to remember. The basic is, if the subject is plural, the verb should be plural. If the subject is singular, the verb should be singular. This is applicable with the finite verbs. Example, she was waiting in the room. So it's a past continuous process. Next is non-finite verb. These verbs, again, finite verb will show you tense. Non-finite verbs will not show you tense. So we need to be careful of these verbs, which look like verbs, but they do not show tense. What do they act like? We will learn as we read further. There are three types of non-finite verbs which we need to remember. Participle, gerund, and infinitive. Participle are usually formed by adding ing or ed. So we know that there are only two participles. Present participle adds ing to the base form and past participle adds ed to the base form. Example, the singing bird was the main attraction of the event. So here ing has been added to form the participle form of the verb. Gerunds. Gerunds are formed by adding ing to a verb and they act as a noun. For example, smoking is prohibited in the hospital. So smoking here is the name of a process and it is acting as a noun. It is in ing form, it is a gerund. Third is infinitive. Infinitive is adding the word to with the base form of the verb. So you get infinitive form of the verb. And they act as a noun, adjective or an adverb. So non-finite are three. It's non-finite, it's not infinite, please remember. Non-finite has three parts, participle, gerunds and infinitives. Second last type which we are going to learn in this video is link verb. Some verbs are followed by either noun or an adjective. Such verbs are called link verbs. And 13th is causative verb. Those verbs which indicate an action which a person or thing does after being affected by someone. So here it is written, causative verb is used to indicate that some person or thing makes, requires, forces or helps to make something happen. So if the verb is being a cause of something, karan, the reason behind it, such verbs are called causative verbs. So dear students, these are the verbs, definition and its type which we have to remember and revise and practice and learn. It is very important chapter. It has always been a very important chapter because there is no sentence in English which can be made without verbs. So keep learning, keep revising, do come up with your doubts, send it to me, I'll address them, and keep learning, keep sharing, stay fit at your home. Remember, Corona is still not gone. So be aware, be safe, and take care of yourself. Bye-bye, everyone. God bless you all.